Is 2014 really the year of wearables? Let's talk about Android Wear and see where Google's gonna be taking the smartwatch concept. It's Marco from PhoneDog, and finally, Google has announced their plans for the smartwatch market. Now, Android Wear is a SDK for developers to make applications for this kind of wearable technology. Now, Google's intention is to partner up with as many manufacturers as they can to make these affordable, wearable, you know, basically a mass market product, because Google can't make them themselves. They have to use OEMs. So currently, I think they have like LG, HTC, Motorola. They have a couple more, including Fossil, like, you know, like the actual like fashion brands from Fossil. So you would see some fashion statement or, you know, fashion looking or good looking watches that you'd want to wear. Now, the software itself kind of looks like a mixture between Google Glass and Google Now. So basically, you'll still have the phrases like OK Google and doing a voice search, but it'll also use the connection between your Android device, I'm guessing. It probably won't work for iPhone Now, maybe later, between your Android device and your smartwatch, and give you things based on location, based on your schedule, your email, or basically anything that will pop up on your Google Now currently would pop up on your smartwatch. So you can do text messaging, you can do emailing, I guess you can call from there. I'm not exactly sure what the hardware will lie, because no one has really shown off what's inside their hardware, just basically what it looks like. So I think there's currently two manufacturers that came out with their designs, and that includes the LG G Watch, which kind of looks like an iPod Nano watch. But the one that everyone's kind of going crazy over, including myself, is called the Moto 360. Now, it's this round, kind of aviation-style dial. It, you know, it looks super, super classic, and it's beautiful. I mean, I think it's one of the best-looking smartwatches I've ever seen, and it's running Android Wear. Now, it's going to be a really interesting concept, and both of those watches are slated for a summer release of this year, so it means we don't have to wait so long to finally get wearable technology that I'm hoping will be affordable. Now, the second part of the story is that Google has announced that they're working with many manufacturers to make this product. So we could see quite a buttload of smartwatches by the end of this year. Another spectacle is that HTC is also slated to be making a smartwatch running Android Wear. We could see it as early as next week at their HTC event. It could be the first actual watch to be available. So it's all going to be really interesting to see where Android Wear goes, how many manufacturers actually go into making this smartwatch concept and making it into real products, and also how affordable these products will be, because I mean, the Gear 2, it's looking to be a pretty expensive product, around $200. If they could make these things for $100 or less, it would be a blessing from all the manufacturers, and everyone would love to have something as cool and retro looking as the Moto 360 or the LG G Band, or basically anything that's running Android Wear. So yeah, if they make it for under $100, it would be completely amazing, and everyone would be wearing around with something running Android Wear, and Android and Google would be all a happy wearable community, and that would be great. So it's going to be completely interesting to see how this plays into the wearable society and how people will actually accept these wearables in terms of technology and how the software runs, and also the applications that will be made for these tiny, you know, 320 by 320 displays, especially that round dial. It's going to be really interesting to see how that interacts with everything. So yeah, let me know what you think about Android Wear, the Moto 360, the LG G Watch, basically anything that you've seen so far and everything that you want to see in the next couple months from HTC and all the other manufacturers. So make sure to leave a comment below, like this video if you found this helpful, and also please do subscribe for future videos here at PhoneDog's YouTube channel. My name is Marco Hanna from PhoneDog.com, and I'll see you guys in the next video.